Here we have a perpendicularity example, and specifically what we're wanting to do is to control a hole feature such that a fastener bolt at very specific size and geometric tolerance will fit into that bolt under a certain installation requirement, and that just happens to be a minimum clearance of 5/1000ths on diameter. So our fastener is 1/4 inch 20 UNC. Datum A is the mating surface of the head, and we have a perpendicularity on diameter of 2/1000ths. Now this is applied at regardless of feature size, and by default that geometric tolerance applies to the axes as derived from the pitch diameter. So how do we go about determining the right tolerances as well as assigning the most correct perpendicularity tolerance to our clearance hole? Now for this example, I want to ignore the counterbore feature. Let's simply assume that it is very clear of the bolt head and will not pose any sort of a problem. So first things first, we know that the mating surface of the fastener will touch the bottom of that counterbore feature, and I'm going to call that datum A. Ultimately, we're going to have a perpendicularity tolerance. We're going to ignore the positionals for this example. Just as a reminder, in the ASME Y14.5 2009 standard, it is now recognized that angularity is equal to perpendicularity, and they can be used interchangeably when we have a perpendicularity example or squareness. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to assign a feature control frame. I'm going to associate it with the size. That means it'll be applied to the axes. And then I'm just going to use my angularity symbology. And we know it's the same as perpendicularity. My tolerance boundary is going to be diametric. So first thing we need to do is take the boundary information that we do know. And in this case, I'm going to calculate the outer boundary size of my fastener. And the maximum material condition of a 250/1000ths diameter fastener is going to equal to 250/1000ths, equal to the major diameter size. And we have a perpendicularity of 2/1000ths, so I'm simply going to add that. Here we've got 252/1000ths diameter. Now, in the upper left of the screen, we do have a requirement that we have 5/1000ths clearance on diameter in a worst case scenario. So we're going to calculate what that boundary is with the clearance for our hole feature. And in this case, I'm going to add 5/1000ths. So my inner boundary of my clearance hole feature is going to be 257/1000ths. Okay, that's great. So we now know what the innermost boundary of our clearance hole is going to be. So let's write down the equation for our inner boundary. What we're going to do on our hole feature is we're going to take the maximum material condition size, then we're going to subtract that perpendicularity tolerance, whatever it is, and then we know cumulative of size and geometric tolerance that we're not going to be smaller than a diameter of 257/1000ths. Okay, so where do we get the numbers for this hole? Well, on Engineer's Edge, we have a drill size chart as well as a drilling tolerances capabilities chart. Now, we know that our minimum hole size, cumulative of size and tolerance, is 257 thousandths. ANSI size drill bit chart. So I'm going to find 257-ish. Here it is. But we know that our hole is probably going to be a little bit bigger. Probably a 261, maybe even a 1764, so G. So we know we have a drill bit that probably works. Now, at 250 thousandths plus, how accurate can we manufacture that hole feature? So if you come to the machinist drilling mechanical tolerance capabilities chart, you'll see that between, it looks like 251 thousandths to half an inch, that the hole size would probably be somewhere around plus six minus one thousandths. And this is easy to manufacture, shouldn't be any surprises, reaming isn't required. So plus six minus one. And let's write that down. I'm going to say that my tolerance, T, is equal to plus 6 thousandths and minus 1. So now I need to know what my perpendicularity is going to be. Well, going back to our chart, we give information, mechanical location tolerance capabilities chart. Now, this is a recommended positional tolerance. However, we know that positional tolerances include orientation control as well. So it's safe to say that if we can, as manufacture, that hole feature at a positional tolerance, we can also, as manufacture, a perpendicularity tolerance to same, if not a little bit better. So what I want to do is, let's just assume we're going to use precision milling or CNC machine with a fixture, and a tight tolerance is positional tolerance of 8 thousandths, which would be a plus or minus 4 if we were using limit tolerancing methods. So, positional tolerance, I'm going to say it's a diameter of 8 thousandths. Okay, so now we have some information. This is equal to our tolerance. So I'm going to rewrite this equation. I'm going to say, using some algebra, a diameter of 0.257 plus our tolerance, which is a diameter of 8 thousandths, should equal to our maximum material condition size. So we know that we're larger. So in this particular case, maximum material condition size should equal to a diameter of, it looks like 265 thousandths. All right. So our variability of that hole size is plus 6 minus 1, and our MMC size is 265 thousandths. So let's go ahead and start putting some of this information in. And we know that this is 0.08. I'm going to apply a material modifier to this, maximum material condition. We would have to explore exactly what's going on in this application, but we're just going to assume that we want that maximum material condition bonus tolerance. So a diameter, my MMC is going to be the lower limit, which is 265 thousandths, 0.265, and then our upper limit looks like we're going to allow a variability of 7,000s total, I would add 7,000s to that 265,000s. And so that's going to be 0.272. Okay. So, based on our manufacturability of that particular size hole, as well as the positional tolerance converted into a perpendicularity tolerance, we calculated an inner boundary based on the maximum material condition plus our tolerance to achieve these tolerances. Don't forget that this is a very generic case and application, and I do recommend that when sizing fasteners and clearance hole features that your organization establish an industry or a manufacturing practice